The year is 1812. Wellington is fighting the Peninsular War. Napoleon is battling the Russians at Borodino. The Prime Minister, Spencer Percival, is assassinated in the Houses of Parliament. And King George III is barking mad. Here in Walton, things weren't nearly as exciting. However, for one group of people, 1812 was a special year because it was the year in which they opened their new building to the public on the 1st of October. Which building is that, you might ask? Well, it's the Maidstone Road Baptist Church building. And of course, I'm Maidstone Road's current minister. The building itself looks nothing much from the street. In fact, I don't really think it looks very churchy. But it's quite historic, as it's the oldest nonconformist chapel in the Felixstowe area. The Baptist Church was actually founded in 1808. We had our bicentenary 4 years ago, and this building replaced a temporary structure. In fact, Baptists started worshipping on this site in 1802 as an offshoot of Stoke Baptist Chapel in Ipswich. Over the years, it's been altered considerably, but originally it was built in a simple style of what was then called Baptist meeting houses. It was a simple and rustic chapel with a schoolroom to the side surrounded by a graveyard. Down the years, this building's been known by different names. The Baptist Meeting House, Walton Baptist Chapel, Walton Baptist Church, and from the 1930s, Maidstone Road Baptist Church. But despite the changing names, there's been a continuity of worship on this site since it was purchased by a corn merchant called Abraham Kersey Cowell in 1802. He was appointed minister of the church in 1811 in time to see the construction of this permanent building in 1812. The original internal decoration had box pews downstairs with upstairs seating on benches and a balcony. It was pretty basic, but such was the nature of country chapels. In fact, it was so basic and cheaply built that just 70 years later, it was in danger of collapse as the roof was too heavy for the walls. It was time for a fundamental refurb, and in 1897 the building was gutted, a new roof put on, the walls strengthened, the windows altered, and the whole interior orientation changed by 90 degrees with a new balcony and pulpit, which also increased the seating capacity. It's quite a difference, as you can see from the present day photo in the same position. The outside changed too, not just from the 1897 refurbishment, but from additions made as the needs of the church have resulted in extensions to the building. The church buildings are a good example of how changing years often bring changing requirements on how a building is used. So these changes to the building reflect how the church fellowship has changed over the years in how the church worships and serves the community, as well as modern comforts and technology. More recently, pews have given way to comfy chairs, and even the old pulpit has disappeared as styles of worship have changed. That said, we've always tried to keep a bit of the old to remind us of the continuity we have with the past. So, for example, our side panelling is actually the remains of the old box pews. And this was the old balcony front. This panelling was once part of the pulpit. As the building has been modernised in successive decades, the remains of the older stuff has been recycled into the new decor, as well as keeping many of the original features. Of course, if you want a genuine Victorian backsliding experience, well, we still have some genuine Victorian pews up in our balcony. For myself, I prefer the comfy chairs downstairs. But why keep this little reminder of the past upstairs? Well, there's one practical reason, and that is it's not really cost-effective to actually change these pews into something more comfortable. But also, to me, this old stuff still around the building is a reminder of what God did through his people here in Walton in past decades. We serve God and the community of Walton today because of the work and witness of people in the past. We climb on their shoulders to continue what they started and to serve the community and be a witness to the life-changing power of Jesus. Jesus is just as relevant to people here in the 21st century as he was when these walls were first raised in 1812. So it's an interesting building and it's still very much in regular use. But I've got one particular interesting fact to give you about this building, and that is, it isn't a church. The sign outside may say Mason Road Baptist Church, but this building definitely isn't a church. Before you get too confused, let me explain that the word church is the English translation of the Greek word ecclesia. Greek was the language in which the New Testament in the Bible was written. Ecclesia means an assembly or meeting. A church is a gathering of people together. So the church isn't the building, it's the people. And this building has played host to Mason Road Baptist Church, the people, for 200 years this year. So let's have a look back and look again at Mason Road Baptist Church. This time, not a building, but what it really is, the people. So church isn't about buildings, whether they be modern buildings or funny looking buildings or old buildings. What it's about is about people, the desire of people who follow Jesus to want to come together to worship, to serve their community, to have fellowship together, to learn more about Jesus, to pray to him, and to tell others about the wonderful fact that God wants to know every man and every woman, and that's why Jesus has died for them. We welcome people of all ages and all backgrounds here at Mason Road. Whether you're somebody who's been a Christian for a long time, or whether you're just searching for the meaning of life and of faith, you'd be very welcome to contact us and to look at our website and maybe even drop into one of our activities. So thanks for listening, and God bless you.